What's up, YouTube? This is part 14 of my Pokemon Sapphire walkthrough. Alright, last time we went through a whole lot of trainers and through this volcanic area. So, we're in... just going out of Falabar Town, actually, and there's this guy here. And you can actually grab TM5 off him if you want to use it. That's raw, obviously, and that's for our phasing move. So, okay, this is a little... just a little patch of trainers up or down this area until we go into Meteor Falls. Okay, so just a few things in this area you can catch. Let me see, Barb Roach, Geodude, Goldene, both Lombre, Lotad, Magikarp, of course, Marill, Surskit, and Ruby. You can just see the little red squares there, they're Ruby Pokemon. You can get Zangoose, Nuzleaf, Seed Dot. So they're the actual ones you get. You can catch in Ruby, so just a little comparison between the versions there. Okay, so let me see. Well, we've got a trainer here, he's got a Goldene. I'm just gonna train up my Swallow a little bit more. And yep, a lot of comments asking if I'm going to get any more Pokemon in my team. Yes, I am. Very, very close to getting another one. So just, yeah, just hang on, basically. I will eventually get another one. Or another few, actually. Okay, so Goldene goes down pretty easily. And this guy has a Barbroach. I was thinking of getting one of these as well. But I've actually, a lot of these Pokemon have actually already gone through the entire game with. So I want to try and keep it a little bit different and go through... something else. Okay, so he went down pretty easily, 354 experience points, another Goldene. He has four Pokemon, so quite a few Pokemon on here. So after we after you beat this guy, we're gonna go down south, and there's a lot of trainers there you can verse, and we're gonna go into Meteor Falls, basically, and that's where you get another encounter there with yeah, the bad guys. So we're gonna have another little skirmish there. So there's quite a few trainers on the way that I actually want to verse, just purely for some experience, basically. Okay, so picnic out Nancy. She's got a Marill. So basically, they're gonna have a lot of Pokemon already found in this area as well, obviously, because they are found here. So Marill's gonna go down to one wing attack and. Not very much experience from Marill there. Lombre is going to come in next. Oh, I'm just going to keep it in, what the hell, level 30, that'd be cool. So Lombre comes in at level 19. Wing Attack is going to take him out really, really comfortably because that is super effective damage. Okay, so 573, and that takes me to level 30. Okay, so player defeated Nancy. That's another one down. 304 Pokédollars in my wallet. Okay, there's the berry house here. We can get, well, we can get some more berries. I think you get a free one or so. I'm just going to head down here. Yeah, I'm going to battle these. May as well battle these twins. Yes, Tyra, and what's her name? We'll check what the other one's name is. I always like these double battles. They're always lots of fun. Okay, so Tyra and Ivy would like to battle. They have a Roselia and a Graveler. Always reminds me of the time I sent a shiny Graveler, and it used Explosion. Alright, so basically Double Kick for the Graveler and Ember for the Roselia. So, oh, sorry, Drip Steel Wing. I just wanted to test out my Steel Wing. It didn't actually kill him, but that's alright. So Ember for the Roselia. I probably should have done it the other way around, Derp. Anyway, Roselia is obviously going to go down to that Ember. 309 experience points each. Gravel is going to go for a defense curl. Luckily, no self-destruct or anything like that, which is very, very handy. So Steel Wing is going to miss. Awesome. I love that accuracy. Ember's probably not going to kill. Oh, it just does. Awesome. So Gravel is going to go down. And that should give a nice experience. So 301 for both Pokemon there. So I defeat the twins. And 672 Pokédollars for winning that one. Okay, so after them, I'm going to talk to this guy here. So, yep, there's a whole line of berries there as well. And he gives you a Pinup Berry. So I'm going to put that in my berry pocket there. And this is the Lynette's house there. Sorry, did I say that was a berry house? I meant Lynette's house, derp. You can go here, there's some notes and stuff here, but there's not really much here at the moment. I'm not going to keep reading. Lance, obviously, the another person involved with your PC and your Pokemon. So, yep, battle this guy here. And there's another little indent in the wall there for a secret base. I think I had a secret base there once when I used to have Ruby. Good time. So, I've got another trainer here, Campus Shane. He's got two Pokemon. He's got a Sandshrew. He must have caught that in the route before. Let me see. Wing Attack should be my best bet against Sandshrew, doing damage. Just hangs on and goes for the Defense Curl. That's not really going to faze me at all, because he's not obviously carrying any rock moves, or didn't use a rock move against me, so that's fine. Anyway, so Sandshrew goes down, and 378 experience points. So his last Pokemon is a Nuzleaf. And this is... Oh, this is a Ruby, only Ruby Pokemon, so now he's going to go down to a Wing Attack. So it does show you for the Ruby Pokemon you can actually catch, probably just for a page in your Pokedex so you can see. Anyway, so yep, way too strong, damn right, 304 Pokedollars for winning. So there's another guy in the grass here, let me see, I should battle, Pokemon battle, okay, Survivor, that's pretty cool. I've actually... Funny thing is, I've actually gone through the Elite Four with a Survivor before, so yeah, and plus I don't have any ball, I don't have any balls, I don't have any Pokeballs left, so not really going to worry about that. So there's this guy in the grass here, Ufu Ufu or something, Fufu Fufu, whatever, Fifi Fofum, something like that. So he's dressed in like half a dinosaur suit, so yeah, I'm thinking what the fuck, he's got an arrow on level 20, I cannot do absolutely anything to this thing, even though I'm 10 levels high, none of my moves are very effective against it at all, and defense is Aaron's main key. Okay, so Aaron's going to go for a headbutt, that's not going to really do anything to me. Double kick, of course, is super effective against Aaron, so one should take it out with ease, because I'm 9 levels higher. Okay, so Aaron goes down there, 205 experience points, and another trainer defeated. Yes, $1,200. Oh, that guy gave me quite a bit of cash. So, another battle. Let's see what comes up. Another Survivor. This thing really wants me to catch it. So, obviously I'm just going to run away. Just wanted to show you a few Pokemon in the grass there, rather than fast forward through it. Okay, so another indent in the wall, secret base you can put there. So yeah, we're going to enter like this mountainy, rocky bit before we go into Meteor Falls. There's a few more trainers here before we go into it, so... Yeah, okay, so Bernie's got a Slugma, so we've seen this before, I'm pretty sure, so we'll go for a Wing Attack here, that should probably take it out, actually, in one shot. Okay, so 316 experience points, nearly level 31, and he's got a Wingull, Wing Attack should take that out with ease. So level 19, a lot of the Pokemon in this level, in this area are level 19, so... Yeah, that's probably the standard you have to be up to. It's pretty easy, but obviously it'd probably be a bit hard if you had all six Pokemon, because you'd be sharing all the trainer battles around, and your levels wouldn't probably be as high as this if you didn't do a lot of grinding in the area, I guess. Anyway, so beat that trainer, then head down here. There's this guy here. Well, might as well talk to him anyway, so if you're not prepared, you shouldn't be up in the mountains. Well, I am prepared, so... I've got a feeling this guy's going to have a rock Pokemon of some type, hence Geodude. So I've got my Combusken here, so he's got double kick, so this should be very, very easy for him. It should be one shot nearly, two shots down, nearly. So Geodude goes down, he's level 18, he may have a Graveler actually, in before Graveler. So 331, so he goes into his next Geodude. Could be wrong about the Graveler. Double kick is going to take the Geodude out yet again. So double kick's very nice there. I am looking forward to Combusken letting Sky Uppercut. That's kind of his signature move in this gen, in my opinion. So Geodude. So he didn't have a Graveler, but that's all right. One more Geodude. A few more Pokemon will actually be level 30, so that'll be nice. Rounding off level 30 for both of my Pokemon. Okay, so Geodude is going to go down to a super effective double kick. That's three Geodudes down in a row there, so 331 experience points, and I beat Hiker Lucas, so 720 Pokedollars there. So we head on up these little stairs here. There's a few breakable rocks there if you want to go into different areas, and probably other items that I've missed along the way. I'm not going to yodel because I'll probably, like, ear rape you. Anyway, so another hiker dude, so hiker Lenny set up a Machop, and I've got wing attack, so that's super effective. Wing attack, what am I going on about? Heck. So that doesn't kill him, derp. So Ember is going to finish him off. Karate Shot does absolutely nothing to Machop, and that's a crit. And Machop's going to go down there, so 357, and I get my level 30. So I'm actually not far off evolving. Got Buskin, actually. So, let me see, Machop again. Go for a peck, let's hope I can one hit KO in this time. Nearly does it. So, focus energy. So he's going to try and go for a crit, but that's too bad. I am faster, and he doesn't have any moves that will hit me first. And he's not faster, which I just said. Derp. So, 357 experience points there, and 760 Poke Dollars for beating this hiker. So, he's defeated, and we can see the entrance now. Go down the stairs, and in we go. Into the hole we go. Oh, damn, that was probably the wrong thing to say. So, we got Team Aqua here, and they're trying to con this little scientist dude here. Okay, so I'll hold it right there. Team Aqua. So here comes Archie strutting his stuff, and we're going to have two confrontations of both of these little guys. So they're going to run off, and these guys are going to follow in hot pursuit. So fine, sir, you're a pimp. I'm actually of the Team Magma. Yes, basically they both have their own little opinion on ground, land mass and water mass, and yeah. Okay, so in here, Bagon, Barbroach, Golbat, Goldeen, Lunatone, Solrock, Whiscash, and Zubat. I once caught a shiny Golbat in here. Awesome, that was green. Bagon is very tempting for a Salamence, but I kind of want to go a bit different, and I'm going to get a different Dragon Pokemon to that. So I know I have to go back now, but I'm just going to quickly show you a little part of this cave. Meteor Falls, that is. So I'm going to run away from that, Zubat. So you can head down here, and there's actually a little area down here that you don't actually get to access, but you can access going down Meteor Falls. So I'm going to quickly show you that little area anyway. Not that you really need to go there, there's nothing of real importance. You can jump down these little ledges if you like. It's kind of like a shortcut, so, and you can go back up those steps if you want to get out of there, basically. So that's your ways out. There's only really one way in and out. So, okay, so Zubat level 17 here. We're just going to run from that because it's really no point battling that. So run away, and obviously Solrock there is a ruby one. Okay, so location route 115. So Jigglypuff, Magikarp, Pelipper, Swellow, Little Tailoo, Tentacool, Wailmot, and Wingull, and Swablu. So, there's a battle here, Black Belt Knob. Don't need to say anything else. Machop level 20, Peck, enough said. That should nearly kill, nearly. Another Peck should finish him off, and he goes for the Leer, that's really not going to do anything else. Okay, so another Peck will finish Machop off. As I said before, this area you don't actually need to go into. There's a ledge there, you can't actually access it before, so it's not mandatory, but you can still go in there anyway. So, after you beat him, I'm just going to save it here, and that's all for this episode, and thank you for watching.